Hello everyone, and welcome to a painting tutorial by Static Grass Creations. My name is Jason, and today I will be painting a circle of Orboros feral Warpwolf. The majority of my paints are from Games Workshop, and a few are P3 paints from Privateer Press. The techniques I will be using today will be layering, dry brushing, and highlighting. I start off with the model primed white, and I base coat the whole model, except the armor, in Games Workshop's Baneblade Brown. Once the paint is fully dry, I layer on a 2-to-1 mix of Administratum Gray and Baneblade Brown into the raised areas of the body. I layer on paint to the skin and fur as well. Using Rhinox Hide, I add a matte painting medium to the paint to increase the flow. I then shade in the clothing of the model. I also fill in the recesses in the clothing. The medium helps keep with the paint from drying too quickly and makes it easier to blend the paint. I also use the Rhinox Hide to paint in the leather straps and rope. I use Caliban Green to base coat the inside of the armor. Thank you. slightly watering down Nulin oil, I wash the skin and fur of the Warpwolf. Once the wash is completely dry, I then use P3's Menoth White Highlight to dry brush and highlight the fur. A small amount of Games Workshop's Abaddon Black is used to paint the mouth. Moving back onto the armor, I layer on top of the base coat using Warpstone Glow. The Warpwolf's clothing is then highlighted using Baylor Brown, creating quite a difference between the skin and the clothing. I avoid the mid-tone areas and stick to the ends and raised areas of the clothing, and then I also use Baylor Brown to highlight the leather straps and rope. Using P3's Menoth White base, I paint the nails and shoulder spikes of the Warpwolf. with Games Workshop Ustabu Bone. I highlight the nails and shoulder spikes. Rhinox hide is then used to paint the flock on the base. Mechanicus Standard Grey is used to paint the stone necklace. Moving back onto the armor, Orboros Green is then highlighted into the inset areas. This highlight is kept to the center of the plating to accentuate the curvature of the armor. Lead Belcher is applied to the rings of the straps and the hooks of the necklace. A highlight of Runefang Silver is applied over top of the silver areas. Administrative Gray is highlighted onto the stones. Moving on to the eyes, they are painted with P3's Sanguine Highlight and then highlighted with Games Workshop's Troll Slayer Orange. Manoth White Highlight is then used to paint the teeth. Finishing the armor, P3 solid gold is used to paint the raised designs on the plates. Moving on to the base, a heavy dry brush of Menoth White base is used, followed by a lighter dry brushing of Games Workshop's Ushabti Bone. Once that's done, Abaddon Black is applied to the rim of the base. Warpstone Glow is used to trace and fill in a 180 degree arc on the base. Multiple layers of paint are needed to create a smooth finish. Finishing off the base, once the rim is dry, static grass is applied using regular white glue in random patches on the base. I then create patches of snow using secret weapon miniatures, crushed glass, and realistic water kit. I want to make it more wet looking, so I added a little bit more water effects to the mix. I applied the snow mix directly to the base using a sculpting tool.